Can you remember the first thing that you did?
Yeah.
Because there was a place on 12th Street called Prince Adams Records.
That was my place. Girl, me and a lady named Ruth Adams.
Is Prince a guy?
Prince, this guy was supposed to be a partner, and we just named the company after Prince and Adam. It didn't make any difference to me. Yeah. We just took the same thing as a record shop name.
Remember Rudy Robinson?
Rudy, I did his first record.
Yeah, Red Pepper.
Red Pepper, yeah.
Yeah.
Roosevelt Fountain and the Pens of Rhythm. Yeah. Rudy Robinson played organ. We had Freddy Butler, guitar. Big Bubbles on drum. Big fat dude.
It's an upright bass on that song, is it?
Yeah.
On Red Pepper.
Recorded that at on Grand River near Martin.
Correcto?
Correcto!
Because Wilbert Golden, did he give you a couple of suits for it or something?
No, he never got anything, and I didn't either, because he didn't publish it. He was supposed to publish it. Wound up getting published out of Jubilee Records out of New York. They the one got the money. Yeah.
M&M label.
M&M Freddy Butler. Yeah.
What was M? One M is for Motley. What's the other M for?
No. It's named after Freddy's two kids.
Who were they? What were their names?
No, what were them kids' names?
Michael.
And what the girl name?
Michelle. Michael and Michelle.
That's right. Yeah.
Pitter Patter.
Pitter Patter, yeah.
And Boogie Twist.
Pitter! My heart is going pitter, and then it goes patter. Oh, darling, won't you please help me solve this matter?
You've always got three digits. Is this when you were playing numbers or something? Hey?
Yeah, no, but I wasn't playing numbers back then. I just used a three-digit number, you know?
Okay, yeah, but there's no order to them, is there? You just think of a number?
Just think of a number and boom. The guy used to own United Sound, Jim Syracuse. And he said, well, you need a record number. 447, I said, okay, let's go. We go with that.
After that, you just stuck with it?
Yeah, I just stuck with it, yeah.
Those sort of numbers, 4 and a 7.
Yeah.
You've usually got 7, and you've usually got 4 somewhere.
Yeah.
The record I've got, Danny, I've got 2. I've got one by Katrina Lynn.
Katrina Lynn? Yeah, I did a thing on Katrina. I forgot about that one. Yeah.
Yeah, talking about
She's
my
a
man.
Preacher now. Yeah? Talking about my man. No. This is something that she wrote.
Talking about my man. Talking about my man. Talking about my man. He's a loving man.
Where did you get the name Sage from?
Sage was Anguard. Anguard Records. That's the biggest one stop in the city.
Hot and Cold Dinner. It's called Hot and Cold.
Yeah, I remember that one. That was an instrumental, yeah. I knew the guitar player for some time. And they was playing at a bar. And they wanted to cut this thing. And so I took them down to United Sound and recorded.
Same-o,
that's the, I'm still using that.
That's Sam Motley, obviously.
Sam Motley, that's right, that's my name.
Yeah, did anybody give you any money for that one? That was just your money.
That was my money.
Yeah.
That was my money, yeah.
Freddy Butler, I'm Not Afraid.
Yeah.
Storms that come and go, but darling.
The Soul Partners, Watch Me Now.
Soul Partners, man, I forgot all about those guys.
Wonder where you recorded these?
It was a studio out there on studio in Hamilton near Wales.
Was it a guy called Major Reynolds?
Major Reynolds, that's right, exactly. These guys hang around over there, and Major don't got no money either. I had a few bucks there, you know. So they had cut part of it. So we went down to United Sound and overdubbed the rest. And I mixed it at United Sound. Down, down, down.
Then you got Ray Redman with a
gay...
I always think Ray's a white guy.
No.
The gay lets were...
Somebody just put that down there, but...
Because that's a nice record. Both sides are good. King, I was told, was you.
I were.
Is it?
Yeah.
You, innit? You're the Rhythm King.
Yeah.
Party time.
Yeah, party time one and two.
Man, chicken. Hey!
The Admirals, Al Watson, is
that's
it?
That's Al Watson. I'm talking about Al Watson. That's who that is.
Yeah, I thought it might be.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I think it says Al Watson on the label.
Yeah, yeah. This was this thing that me and Johanna did out to out in Brighton, Michigan. Danny Dollar. You ever heard of him?
Danny Dallas?
Yeah.
The engineer?
Yeah. Yeah, well, he had a place out in Brighton.
I think he was the engineer at Special.
He was. See, he started at Special. The first thing he ever cut was rock and roll was on a guy named Chuck Off.
Timmy Shaw, send me back to Georgia? Or
yeah, send me back to Georgia, yeah. Apparently they went out of business.
Special did.
Then he went to United Sound, and he stayed at United Sound for a while. Then he quit there. Greek kid, but he was good. We got him when he was 16 years old, yeah.
Raldo,
yeah.
And what does Raldo stand for then? Any idea?
This was this guy I was telling you about had the money for the government office.
Oh, Gerald.
Yeah, he named that after his kid. This guy was an office boy. He had some money. He didn't have what I thought he had. But he had enough to do with what I needed to do.
You got Big Bubbles.
That was the drummer.
Big Bubbles and the Soul Brothers.
Ginger Snap. Yeah.
You like the instrumentals?
Yeah, but I sold some records with instrumentals. I sold a few of them.
did you go about selling your records then, once you got them pressed up? What did you do?
Well, you see, I was kind of pretty good with the distributors here. Right. One of the reasons why, because I was kind of easy going, easy to get along with.
You didn't go around the record stores?
No.
Taking boxes of 25 or?
500.
Taking 500 records?
500 records. I was pressed up 1,000.
I see that these ones on the Raldo label, they were pressed up at the Columbia plant.
Right, they were pressed at the Columbia plant down at Terre Haute.
Right, so
Terre Haute, Indiana.
So you'd have 1,000 of them pressed.
We have 1,000 of them pressed, take 500 down.
To Record Row.
To the distributor. It was mostly on consignment, like, yeah.
You don't get any money until he sold them.
Until he sold them.
Yeah, so it's a risky business.
It was a risky business. Record business is a gamble. Always has been. You don't never, man, listen, man, you know, man, you can go out there and cut the best record in the world, and it don't have to sell. And you go out there and cut some garbage, and you're sold out before you get back home. What's his name? Your Love Was So Wonderful by Sonny Allen. Joe Hunter, he helped me to arrange that. Joe Hunter, Don Roby down at Houston, Texas.
Oh, yeah. Duke Records. Peacock.
Peacock and the other, the Duke label. Mm-hmm. Thing, These Hands. Yeah, we did that here at United Sound. Yeah. Joe and I. Yeah, sure did. We did a couple of things on Al Bragg's. We did stuff on Gene Chandler. Yeah, over Chicago, yeah.
Oh, you went to Chicago.
Yeah, we went over there and did Universal.
Hey, do you remember a guy called Jim Holland?
Yeah, James Holland. Frankly, I remember him and I with a thing, and we carried it to Chicago. And I went and hoped James to lease that record over to them. James Holland. This is one of the reasons why I went into so many of the instrumentals. You know,
you didn't know all those instrumentals.
Right. Because I didn't listen to the lyrics. Lyrics didn't mean anything to me. But I had to find out that the lyrics were Big Barney, Belladius Partner, when they had the Westbound label, Big Barney. We're about 400 pounds.
Sugar Babe.
And at that time, you could cut records for little or nothing back then. I can remember paying $10 a side, man. I could take $250 and put it back on the street. They were giving us like 41, 42 cents a copy.
How much would it cost you to press them up?
It was about 9 cents a copy.
It cost you 9 cents a copy?
Yeah.
And you'd sell it for
42 cents.
So it was like you'd make like 30 odd cents on each 45 sold.
That's right. When you get through with everything, you're going to, with paying the artists, you're going to wind up making somewhere like maybe 22, 23 cents.
Of all the people in the world, there's but one I chose to love, and it was you. You're my love right from the start, though many times you broke my heart and made me blue.